The Neil Simon, formerly the Alvin Theatre, was built in 1927, near the end of the Broadway building boom. It was designed by Herbert J. Krapp for two prominent producers of musicals, Vinton Freedley, born into a wealthy Philadelphia family, and Alex Ahrens, a second-generation showman.
And Alvin seems like an odd name for a theater until you understand that it was built for the productions of Alexander Ahrens and Vinton Freedley to get Alvin as the name of the theater. And they design a very rich 18th-century English-American-inspired red brick building with beautiful white terracotta ornament on the exterior. The interior of the Neil Simon Theater uses the Adameque English ornament in the most elegant manner of any Broadway theater. And it's really capped off by an extraordinary mural over the proscenium arch.
Throughout the 20s and 30s, the Neil Simon captured the mood of the country with screwball comedies and sophisticated musicals, including Fred and Adele Astaire and Funny Face, Ethel Merman's debut, and George Gershwin's masterpiece, Porgy and Bess.
Oh, I got plenty of nothing, and nothing's plenty for me.
For the next three decades, the theater remained a force on Broadway, with plays and musicals that would become classics. And then, in 1977, the Nederlander Organization bought the theater and presented a Depression-era story about a little orphan girl. It would become a surprise sensation.
And everything's gonna be fine, boy. For the both of us.
Annie was a show that should have never been. Everybody rejected it at the beginning. And we persevered, and we were suddenly the biggest hit in the world.
So don't worry,
Little Orphan Annie is a story of the 1930s. It has a redemptive element to it that is very appealing.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun.
In 1981, 21-year-old Matthew Broderick auditioned for the lead role in Brighton Beach Memoirs, a comedy by Neil Simon in which he would portray the playwright.
I mean, I was playing him, you know, as a kid. He was very concerned about his material and all. And I heard him laugh when I auditioned. I could hear him laugh. When he likes something, it's the greatest feeling. And he did like it, so it was a very happy partnership. Partnership, it's his play, but, you know, for what it's worth.
In 1983, Brighton Beach Memoirs opened and was an instant hit. A few months later, the theater was renamed.
And it was at that time when they decided to rename it the Neil Simon Theater.
In 1985, Matthew Broderick returned to the theater to star in Biloxi Blues, also by Neil Simon.
It's rare that you get a great part in a play and then the writer decides to write another one. You know, it turned into two parts. So it was great.
In 2002, a colorful musical burst onto the stage of the Neil Simon Theater. Hairspray, based on the John Waters movie, starred Harvey Fierstein as Edna Trumbull.
You can't stop my happiness, cause I like the way I am.
Edna was just a joy, you know, to start out as a 400-pound agoraphobic woman, you know, who's a total mess. And by the end of the show, she's full of herself and out in the world and just exploding with love and happiness and, you know, musical comedy heaven. You can't
stop me. For set designer David Rockwell, the challenge was how to design a set that best reflected the story.
We had a room full of models and sketches, and Jack came in and looked around, and then he put his arm around me and he said, let's find the things that make you fall in love with this chubby girl from Baltimore who believes she's gonna change the world. Let's tell the story from that point of view.
With its rich history of plays and musicals, the Neil Simon Theater epitomizes what draws people to Broadway over and over again.
I've been on Broadway now 30 years, and I'm still as wide-eyed about, oh, look who's coming, and oh, look who's playing here, and I still get that thrill.
When you look at the history of these theaters, they've changed how we think about entertainment. In some ways, they're like a microcosm of what makes the city so great.